Here we are at Budo 55, and we have an amateur MMA contest at 100 kilograms between fighter of the red corner, Elliot Trulove, and fighter of the blue corner, Zach Wilcox.
And on the big boys, here's Guy, 100 kilograms. Throw him one of those bombs landed on his chin, that's for sure.
Could be me and you, Ed.
Think of a bit heavy to be, I'd have to wake up first. This is exactly where Zach Wilcox wants the fight to take place. He's from Satori Jiu-Jitsu, which obviously is grappling heavy. Trulove would much prefer it to be on the feet. And he's already got full mount as Wilcox. He's not going to give this up easily. Could be trouble for Elliot Trulove. He's already given his back up. This is not what you want in this fight to take place.
Referee Chris Clark from Bolton looking very closely, and there we have it.
That is it. Just like that.
First round victory for Zach Wilcox, and we can see how much it means to him. A lot of noise in here in the Neath Sports Centre. He's brought a lot of fans down here.
Obviously, from our vantage point, I couldn't quite see the finish, but I'm assuming with Trulove being barely down, it might have been a rear naked choke. An attack from Trulove. That's one wild tattoo on the back of Trulove. By the look of it, I think it's Al Capone.
Al Capone, yeah.
I'm not sure if it was before the syphilis or after.
Now we can see the fighters chanting, see the respect between them, it's always nice.
Yeah, that's what I love about MMA, Kieran, is no matter what happens, how the fight goes, there's always massive respect.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for more fighters, come on. And your winner, after 1 minute 4 seconds in the first round by rear naked choke, in the blue corner,
what we do have to remember, well, Kieran, is the amount of courage it takes to get in there. Especially when you're 100 kilo, because anyone 100 kilo, they throw a fist at you, it's got 99 kilo behind it. So, I mean, it takes a lot of courage to get in there. Zach Wilcox is absolutely delighted with the win now.
And no doubt he knows himself, if he wants to progress in MMA, he'll have to improve and probably get in a slightly better shape. He's probably under no illusion about that, so it's obviously just a stepping stone for him.
Yeah,
and we will expect to see him come back better, even better again in the future.
Yeah, I agree. I expect to see him on future Budo shows, that's for sure.